Hello friends, today we will learn about swapping values between two variables. First, we will understand what is swapping, then we will write a program where we will swap values between two variables. First, let us understand what is swapping. Suppose we have a variable x that is storing the value 19. Suppose we have another variable y that is storing the value 55. Now swapping the values between variables means interchanging the value. So x will store the value that variable y is storing and y will store the value that variable x is storing. So after we have performed swapping, x will store the value that variable y was storing. Variable y was storing 55, now x will store 55. Y will store the value that variable x was storing. X was storing 19, so variable y will store the value 19. So swapping values between variables means interchanging the value. So the value that variable x was storing, that variable y will store, and y will store the value that variable x was storing. Understanding how to write a program that will swap values between two variables is very important. Because oftentimes when we are programming, we need to swap values between two variables. Next, we will write a program where we will swap values between variables. Suppose x is storing 19 and y is storing 55. Then I will display the value that variable x and y are storing. So first I will display the value of variable x and then I will display the value of variable y. Now if I run the program, you can see x is storing 19 whereas y is storing 55. Next, let's see how we can swap the values that variables x and y are storing. So what I will do is I will write x equal to y and y equal to x. So here I am assigning x the value that variable y is storing, and here I am assigning y the value that variable x is storing. Let me display the value that variable x and y are storing. Now if I run the program, you can see x is storing 55, but y is also storing 55. See, x is storing the value that variable y is storing, but y is also storing 55 rather than storing 15. Let's see what went wrong. So here we are swapping values. Let's understand what is happening. So when we write x equal to y, we are assigning the value that variable y is storing to variable x. Y is storing 55, so x will now store 55. Next, we are assigning y the value that variable x is storing. If you think x is storing 19, that's not the case. Remember, we reassigned x with the value that variable y is storing. Now x is storing 55, so if we write y is x, since x is storing 55, y will also store 55. Let's understand how we can fix this. Remember, when we wrote x equal to y, what is happening is we are assigning x with the value that variable y is storing. Now at this point, we are losing the value that the variable x is storing. So we have to take a backup of the value that variable x is storing. So I will create a temporary variable and I will assign it the value of variable x. So I am taking backup of the value that variable x was storing. Now temp will be storing 19. So we have taken backup of the value that variable x was storing. Now here, instead of writing y is x, I will write y is temp. So I am assigning y with the value that variable x was storing initially. It is 19 here, so y is storing 19. Now if we run the program, you will see x is 55. X is storing the value that variable y was storing, and y is storing the value that variable x was storing. So this way, we can use a temporary variable to swap the values between x and y. Python simplifies things even further. We can use an assignment operator to swap values between two variables. Let's see how we can use an assignment variable to swap values between two variables. So I will write x, y equal to y, x. So here I am assigning the variable x with the value that variable y is storing, and I am assigning the variable y with the value that variable x is storing. Now I will display the value that variable x and y are storing. First I have to comment this out. Now if we run the program, you will see the values are swapped. So x is storing the value that variable y was storing, and y is storing the value that variable x was storing. So this way we can also use an assignment operator to swap values between two variables. Here x is storing 19 and y is storing 55. These are integer type values. We can have value of any data type. This logic will still work. Suppose x is storing some string value like I am legend, and suppose y is storing another string value that is I am column. Now when Python interpreter executes our program, first it will initialize x and y, then we are displaying the value that variable x and y are storing. It will ignore this commented lines, it will not execute them. Then it will perform this operation where it will swap the values. Then again we are displaying the value that variable x and y are storing after swapping. Now if we run the program, you can see the values that variable x and y are storing, they are swapped. Now x is storing the value that variable y was storing, and y is storing the value that variable x was storing. So we can have data of any data type, we can swap using assignment operator. If we comment this out, now if we execute this block where we have used a temporary variable in order to swap values between two variables, now if we run the program, you can see still we are getting the correct output. So the values of x and y are swapped. So we can use a temporary variable in order to swap values, and we can also use an assignment operator, but it's better to use an assignment operator to swap values because this takes fewer lines of code and it saves a lot of our time.